going to pull out some of the elements of this story structure, follows the standard process, as we'll see in a moment. Let's go over basic story architecture first. So when you first start writing and filmmaking, you have a linear perspective in that sense. Pretty soon you realize that both the beginning and the ending are the same, which is why we demonstrate story structure via a loop. We identify the classic beginning and ending as a state of perfection, which is lost, becomes the state of imperfection, the lost phase, the limitations phase, and the process of returning to it is undergone. You can start there or somewhere in between. If you do that, the events, they tend to be referenced at later stages. Most stories end with some form of state of perfection. If you don't want to do that, if you want to end with imperfection or some combination, that's almost irrelevant. The process is always the same. So you're always going to have transformation, change, metamorphosis, transmogrification, psychological journey, the various arcs. You're always going to have physical journey, and you're always moving through new worlds, which really are physical manifestations of new psychological states and new versions of the self. Working your way around the cycle involves jumping through lots of hoops. Each hoop has its own set of sub-stages, which in essence are functions which may be performed, messages which may be communicated. They tell you what tangibles or intangibles you're going in there to acquire, how to construct those sequences. So for example, if that's the old new world, we know it just involves protection, repression, fear of exit, etc. So those sub-stages show you how to construct those sequences. When you are here, you are unable to return, so you have to go forward, grow, learn, mature, let go of the old limitations, come all the way around, in essence, until you're ready to return. So that's basic story architecture. It's the fundamental framework that all successful stories are based around, and I go over that in great detail in the 2100 stage of the Journey Transformation, Movement Through New Worlds and States, which you can purchase off the website. So let's get rid of that. Let's draw another loop so we know now there's much more behind that than a simple circle represents. So we kick off the Wolf of Wall Street and we meet Jordan later on in the cycle where he's already changed. He's already separated from the normal world. He's doing an almost indecent thing of throwing smaller people against the bullseye. So we're going to go through the process, follow how he got to there, and then follow his further journey. So in essence, we then start with the backstory, and as a kid, he did in essence belong to the normal world. So he was a normal kid with normal parents, playing baseball, a normal game, living in a normal part of the city. His parents earned a normal income, but at some point he wanted to go into the other world, which in essence we can call the rich world. So we can look at this story from a few points of view. We can look at it from the point of view of the two worlds and the two selves. We can look at it from the point of view of the damaged self. We can look at it from the point of view of the conflict or choices to be made between two opposite fathers. And we can use shorthand. So the dark side, for example, would be shorthand for misbehaving, behaving unethically, overdoing the women and the drugs. So we've got our hero wants to enter in essence this opposite world, so we arrive in a new world, which in essence is Wall Street, and he's arriving on a bus, which is symbolic of the normal world, and he's saying goodbye to his normal world wife, which in essence is symbolically goodbye to the normal self. And then he arrives in the Wall Street offices, which in essence is the ordinary world. He's told he's lower than pond scum or something like that, so he's low status, and in essence he's invisible. And one of the characteristics of the journey is that the hero will go from low status to high status and in essence become king of the new world, which he does later, and also evolves from being invisible to visible, which also happens later. So then, in essence, we meet our father figure, and it's a father figure because we have Jordan mirroring him later on. And that's where you get a call to adventure, and we've got Mark, in essence, encouraging our hero to the dark side, encouraging him to behave unethically, to top up on the women and the booze and the drugs. So he starts going to strip clubs, so incremental change already starting there. He graduates, passes his exam, and then in essence we're exiled from that world. So the crash, and then the company goes bust, he's pushed out. And so then we journey literally away physically from that. So he's leaving New York, going to Long Island, and that's where you meet your supernatural age and your magical gifts. And so he goes to the investor center, learns about the pink sheets and 50% commission, and also meets Donnie, who is in essence a metaphor for the dark side. So we've got Donnie introducing Jordan to crack cocaine, for example. So performing a similar function to Hannah there. And then we're moving into the first threshold, and we brought a symbolism into it. So physically, we're opening the garage doors to our new premises, and we're going to start up our own business. And from the inner arc point of view, it's aligning himself with this dark archetype, and in essence implicitly agreeing to turn to the dark side. So then they start making money selling dodgy stocks, and the first threshold separation really is when his normal world wife suggests that maybe he should target rich folk because they won't feel the pain so much. So we can see that Teresa, his normal world wife, is already uncomfortable between the two worlds, and in essence is trying to push back. So that in essence causes the big change. So then he starts up the new company name, and we've got our New World allies, who are also damaged, by the way. They're all sort of outcasts and drug dealers, and we evolve from being this dodgy operation on Long Island to, in essence, larger professional offices in Wall Street. So then we get the Forbes article, and the evolution is demonstrated by a new name. So now you're the Wolf of Wall Street, and in essence, you're quite visible. So you've evolved from being invisible to visible, but crucially, it doesn't belong. The rest of Wall Street firms think that he's a bucket shop, and that's the motivation for the IPO, in essence, to belong. We've also got Jordan's father turning up, also a member of the normal world, pulling him back, saying, listen, this is obscene, and that's the physical separation. Jordan agrees, yes, it's obscene in the normal world, but who wants to live there? He wants to be part of this crazy new rich world, and that's in essence the physical separation. And already we see here he's having problems at home, so he's beginning to separate from all of those representations of who he was. So then our deeper new world, demonstrated by this fabulous beach house and these pool parties, and they come up with the idea of the IPO to belong, but also to maintain this new world, because as his father says, the chickens will come home to roost, and in essence, the death of this new world is imminent. And this is a phase where you lose the older self and you layer on the new self, and one of the ways you do that is you strip off those clothes that represented who you were, and you layer on those clothes that represent who you become. And so he divorces Teresa, his normal world wife, and he marries Naomi, which is a symbolic representation for who he's become, his place and belonging in the new world. All the way around, it's seizing the tangible sword, so they win the IPO business, compete against the other Wall Street firms, so they belong, but underneath it's dark, it's damaged, it's corrupt, and that leads us into our underworld sequences. So moving around, we have this almost thematic confrontation between the good and the bad. So we've got Jordan meeting the FBI agent on the boat, and in essence the FBI agent is going to win, and so our world is coming to an end imminently, and all these shenanigans in Switzerland are in essence an attempt to maintain the new world and our position within it. We've also got our confrontation with our ogres at this stage, so we are confronting our damage, and we've got Jordan realizing that he's an addict. We've also got our near-death experience, so this is when he almost throttles Donnie, and Donnie being a metaphor for the dark side. If he were to kill him, he would in essence let go of that dark side, but he doesn't let him live, in essence, or doesn't let go. All the way around, our boon in essence, so this is Jordan making that speech in essence, thumping his chest, humming in the way that Mark Hanna did here. So he's become the father. We've got our atonement, so we've got our real father. We've got the SEC guy, also a father figure, telling him to let go of the new world, but also the dark side, in essence. And Jordan refusing to do that, and then we have the return. And that's done by stripping away all of those representations that represent the new world. So we apotheose, we physically apotheose out. So we're leaving New York and we base ourselves in Italy. We've got Brad who decides that he doesn't want to be part of them anymore. We've got Madden starts selling his shares. We've got our British aunt dies, so we lose all our money in Switzerland. We try to get to Switzerland on time and we lose the boat, we lose the chopper. We've got Jordan desperately clinging on to Naomi, not wanting to let her go, and that's because Naomi represents this new world and who he's become, doesn't want to let that go. But we see her already pulling away, and eventually she divorces him, takes the child, loses the house, and even this failed attempt at sobering up and earning an honest living by becoming a motivational speaker is really a kind of refusal to let go, and that's overcome when the FBI arrests him. So that's the final conflict, and they in essence force him to rat, force him to let go. He refuses it, hands Donnie the napkin, but they force it, and eventually he gives them all up. And then we have the FBI going into the offices, arresting everybody, and that's in essence the end of the new world. And then we in essence have returned to the normal world. We have sobered up and we are earning an honest living as a motivational speaker. So that's the basic deconstruction of that story. If you want a detailed deconstruction of it, you can order it from the website. But once again, showing you that all of these stories follow this process of journey and transformation and movement through new worlds and states, which I go over in great detail in the 2100 Stage of the Journey, Transformation, Movement Through New Worlds and States, which you can purchase off the website.